Hello. Today I'm going to walk you through how to use Jobscan, one of our favorite resume hacking techniques that allows you to really get your resumes into the hands of the companies that you really want to work for. Many large companies use these systems called Applicant Tracking Systems, or ATS, which try to screen out candidates by comparing what's submitted in a resume to what is in the job description. By looking at various things like qualifications, certain keywords, years of experience, etc. This helps large companies quickly filter out their large applicant pool so that they can truly get the resumes that will have an impact into the hands of hiring managers. But unfortunately, many great candidates don't actually make it past this screening process and into the hands of hiring managers. Maybe because they left out certain keywords, didn't have a resume that exactly matched the job description, or for some other reason. Jobscan, thankfully, helps solve that problem. They allow you to upload your resume and the job description, get a score with how closely the two match, and it gives you feedback on how you can improve your resume so that you can make sure you get in the hands of hiring managers. So today I'm going to walk you through an example of how Jobscan actually scans a resume. And I already have a sample resume up for an administrative assistant. So this administrative assistant looks like they have about 12 years of experience, as well as some education, bachelor's of arts in history, etc. So I'm going to use this from Resume Genius, and then I'm going to compare it against a job description for an administrative assistant role at KeyBank. So to do it, I simply load Jobscan. I click on Try Sample Resume and Job. It's going to go through an automated process with a sample tutorial of how to use their tool using a product management resume and job description. I'm going to end this tour so I can walk you through how to use it. Click on Update Resume and Rescan. Go ahead and clear out both the pre-filled sections. This left side is where you're going to copy and paste the resume text. So I'm going to go back to my resume of the administrative assistant, copy everything. You don't have to include contact information, that's okay, but copy everything else. Just paste it right in there. Doesn't need to look pretty. Jobscan will do the rest. Then go and get your job description. So with the job description, you should copy everything from it, including the about the job and the essential job functions and the qualifications, except for the description of what the company is. That will just throw off the scanner. So go ahead and copy and paste that into the job description. You can see here I have the resume on the left and the job description on the right. And then go ahead and click rescan. It'll take a minute or two, and then it'll give you a match rate. So up here, it shows you the overall match rate of this resume compared to the job description. So it's a 31%. Definitely a lot of room for improvement. They have here some high-level scores of ATS findings, recruiter findings, skills match compared to the job description, etc. And if you scroll down a little more, they have some core ATS findings. So this is really what we're going to focus on right now. You can see some X's for skills and keywords. So it says you're missing two important high-level skills on your resume. So we'll dig into that in a second. It says we're good on the job title match, good on the education. ATS tip, adding this company's name and web address can help you provide the ATS specific tips. So if we wanted to, we could add this specific company here as well. It found the education and work experience sections just fine, and the dates were okay, so great. Word count below the maximum suggested. Seems like we're a great fit for this role, but there's a lot of room for improvement on making sure this resume can actually pass these automated screening tools. Page size non-standard, that's okay. Again, this is a premium feature too for Jobscan, so if you wanted to pay for it, you could later. Scrolling down further, this is where you really get to nitty-gritty and the details of what is missing on your resume. So hard skills. There were some hard skills on that resume that we looked at. They were kind of blended into the rest of the resume, but it says here we're missing retail experience. So that must have been a core call out on the job description. Administrative support, also missing. But it's required, it's in the job description. Presentations as well. So these are all these skills are keywords that we should be using in the resume when we want to resubmit it. So we need to make sure we include the keyword administrative support. If going back to the resume, you can clearly see it says they were an administrative assistant, they helped with appointments and meetings, but they did not say specifically administrative support. And this is where the ATS software is not going to pick out those words from the resume and possibly reject this resume. There's a whole list of other hard skills here. You can go through it and make sure that your resume has the skills that are recommended by Jobscan. Going down further to soft skills, these are of medium importance. And you can see here, we're missing a lot of soft skills. Really the only one that our resume has is sensitive. Does not include confidential information, problem solving, and a whole list of other recommended soft skills. So definitely room for improvement here. You can go further and see other keywords. These are of low importance, but nice to have, and they will definitely boost your resume if you can include these. So really what you can do is go through this list, make sure that you have all of the valid keywords as well. And then once you're ready, you can go ahead and update resume and rescan like we did before, and it will rescan your new resume, matching it to the job description. Down here as well are some recommended jobs based on what your resume suggested. Makes it a little bit easier to find some other jobs besides the one that you submitted the job description for. And you can, of course, go to Indeed and search for more of these jobs. So with that, this was your introduction to using JobScan to scan a resume. So thank you for tuning in today and learning a little bit about how to use JobScan. And hopefully this will help you get your next job. So take care.